Hey there, Dani K, coming to you from Dani K Gym and Wellness. Today's tip is about, you know, the gyms or the machines being overwhelming. I know it's the first of the year, and people are, you know, trying to get that New Year's resolution of, you know, losing weight, getting healthy, you know, and all that stuff. But they're, you know, afraid to come into a gym. One, you don't really need a gym, and yeah, I own a gym, but I say you don't really need a gym to actually get your workouts done. You can do a DVD, you know, at home, and maybe at that point, you know, you're exercising, you're getting that flow in, and that kind of gets you feeling better about yourself and encourages you a little bit more to get into a gym. Another thing is to actually check out the surrounding gyms and check out the atmosphere of which that particular gym has. If you walk in, and I know a lot of people have come into my gym, they like it because it's a smaller environment. I'm here all the time to, you know, help you. You know, you don't have to pay me to, you know, say, you know, hey, am I using this this piece of equipment right? You know, I'm here and I want to be able to help you guys do it properly and not injure yourself. So, you know, I'm always available to answer questions, to, you know, show you how certain pieces work and so forth. So, you know, that with my gym, the intimidation factor is down because you don't have to feel like you're going to look like an ass working on a piece of equipment because I'm going to help you. You can ask me. I'm approachable. You can ask me to help you. You know, so, you know, you might want to go in and test, maybe take, you know, a guest pass, you know, at the different gyms and see if you like this atmosphere, if you like the people that might be around the same time, working out around the same time you're working out around. So just remember that this is your fitness journey and these are your goals, and it should be all about you and your comfortableness, you know, with a situation or an area or a gym or an arena, whatever you want to call it, so that you can get out of your comfort zone to actually get the results that you need. You know, another thing that I would suggest, you know, if whatever gym that, you know, you would join, hopefully mine, but whatever gym that you would join, you know, you come in, if you're a little intimidated by everything, you know, maybe just come in and walk on the treadmill, you know, for 15 minutes or something. You know, try that maybe 2-3 days in a row and kind of, you know, kind of get the feel of what's going on in the gym and the different people that are in the gym at the same time. You know, maybe kind of see, you know, nonchalantly, don't like stalk or glare at anybody working out, but, you know, kind of nonchalantly see a piece of equipment that you might want to work on and see how they're using it. Make sure that it's the correct way, obviously, first and foremost. But, you know, and a lot of times there's, you know, things written down on the pieces of equipment. I don't know if you can see this in the background right here. All my machines have that written down as well, like how to actually use the piece of equipment. So most places have that. You know, so after 2 or 3 days, 4 days of just walking on the treadmill and trying to get, you know, acclimated to the atmosphere, maybe walk on the treadmill and then use one piece of equipment. Try that for a couple of days and then try another piece of equipment. So there's different ways of actually working yourself up to and getting that confidence built up to actually, you know, coming into a gym and working out and feeling comfortable. Just because all of the pieces of equipment are here and all the free weights and all that stuff is here doesn't mean that you have to use them all today, you know? All the cardio equipment doesn't mean you have to use it all today. Take your time. You know, you didn't gain the weight or you weren't, you know, feeling, you know, blah about yourself overnight. You know, it's been, you know, months, years, whatever it might be. So, you know, take the time to actually make this a fitness journey that you're going to stay on, because if you don't, if you rush it and you pressure yourself, guess what? You're not going to stick with it. So don't put the pressure on yourself. And, you know, just take the time and go small steps, and then those smaller steps get bigger steps, and you'll do more and more the more you feel comfortable. And, of course, the more you feel comfortable, the more you're going to feel comfortable about getting out of your comfort zone to get those results. So I hope that helps. And, you know, check out all of my other videos on my YouTube channel. You can search DKNYKNIGHT. On YouTube and subscribe to my YouTube channel. You can also reach me at Dani K Gym and Wellness on Facebook. or DaniKGymAndWellness.com. So check out my other stuff. I hope this helps you and helps you on your fitness journey. Please leave your comments. Tell me what you want to hear. Tell me what you're struggling with, and I'll try and help you any way I can. So stay in tune, stay informed, stay motivated. See ya.